creepy. Hey everyone, Templar74 here with another Yu-Gi-Oh! Video, and today's Yu-Gi-Oh! Video is going to be my review of the latest episode of Yu-Gi-Oh! SEVENS, Episode 58, Intertwined Fates. And I gotta be honest with you guys, this episode, now don't get me wrong, this episode was really good and exciting, but at the end of it, I felt a little bit lackluster, and that's probably because this duel's outcome was completely reliant on an outside trope. I hate it when Yu-Gi-Oh! Does that. I've always been a critic of that ever since the Duel Monster days, whenever an outside force affects the outcome of a duel. I always have a gripe about that. I just don't know why. It doesn't matter what the outside force is. I'll always have an issue with it, but again, maybe that's just me, but I'll talk about all this soon enough. So, at risk of further rambling, though, let's move on to the actual episode. So, the episode begins with the Goha presidents here, and we get introduced to the next one that's going to duel, and it's Yuo. And this kid is like the very definition of creepy. He's basically a puppet duelist. He's got a thing with puppets, and he's also planning his own hostile takeover of the entire Goha Corporation, which is kind of funny. It kind of reminds me, this character gives me, like, if you were to fuse Noah Kaiba and Bakura together, though, that's the kind of vibe I'm getting off of this kid. But yeah, Yuo is somebody that really just creeps me out, and you know, it turns out later on that there's a good reason for that. So anyway, we go back to Yuga and company, and Gakuto is holding a meeting about the duel circumstances with the Goha presidents, because now they're tied and they know that they got to win to save the Rush Duel robot here, the Rush Duel program. And it's funny because Rook bails on them to go eat, and we don't really see much of Rook in this episode. Not really a huge loss, if you ask me. But anyway, as they're hanging out in the school after hours, they get interrupted by this creep show of a puppet fest, and it turns out that it's Yuo leading Yuga into a duel. And once Yuo and Yuga confront, the Rush Duel begins almost instantly. And it's a pretty good Rush Duel. It's really anybody's race to call it first. First we see Yuo put Yuga on the back foot, then Yuga pulls a maximum out and throws Yuo on edge with Fast Vulcan. And it's funny because Fast Vulcan here has been kind of in bad shape, so Yuga asked Asuna to repair the cards. It's nice that they're still showing the friendship here from Asuna and Neil and Roa with Yuga as far as the maximum goes. Although I won't lie, I do miss the original opening sequence of Fast Vulcan. This one was still pretty epic. So yeah, but Yuo manages to stop Fast Vulcan from attacking him with a trap card. So Yuga just uses its effects to do effect damage, and then ultimately uses Fast Vulcan's third effect to lower its own attack so that it can attack for game. And before Yuga is able to finish him off with Fast Vulcan, we learn that the Rush Duel robot has just broken arm. And it's the arm that contains the part for maximum summons. So basically, now that this is broken, the maximum summons no longer work. Yeah, and this causes Fast Vulcan to be unable to attack and leads Yuo to bring out a fusion monster. Surprise, surprise, first fusion in Rush Duels, and destroys Fast Vulcan for game. Yeah, that's the trope here, and I'm never really a fan of those tropes. That being said, though, fusion, this new fusion monster was pretty impressive. It was pretty impressive to see fusion in here. It begs the question whether we're going to see extra deck summonings of the various varieties later on. Are we going to see Xyz, Synchro, Pendulum? Are we going to see, well, we won't see Pendulum because now that I think about it, but will we see Link? There's just a vast array of things they can do here, and I will admit that it did spice up this Rush Duel. The whole trope of winning with the outside force just kind of taints the episode for me, and I really don't think that's going to change. The episode was great, though, overall, and I give this episode a 7 out of 10. The only reason why I don't think I could give it any higher is just because of that outside trope that they always seem to throw in every so often. It annoys me every time they do it, and this time was no exception, but it kind of soured the taste of the episode in my mouth, to be honest. And it ultimately led to Yuka's defeat, which I think is complete BS. I think that's shenanigans right there, to quote fellow Yu-Gi-Oh! Tubers. But that being said, everybody, those are my thoughts. And as always, I want to hear yours. So in the comment section down below, let me know what your guys' thoughts were about this week's episode. Did you love it? Did you hate it? Did you think it was just eh? There, what are your thoughts? Just let me know in the comment section down below, because as always, I enjoy hearing from you. All right, everyone, as always, Templar 74 signing off. Have a great day, everybody, and I'll talk to you all next time. Goodbye, everybody.